Hassan Nock. I'm here with the one and only Barry Hunter, the Mox trainer. Thank you for joining us, Barry. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.
Just a couple questions. The biggest challenge after this fight, where is he at mentally? Lamont
is one of the strongest persons in the mental area that I know. Sometimes he got too much fight. And that's the part I got to put a muzzle on. It's okay to get mad sometimes when you got control anger. You know, and if you can control and direct it in the right direction, you know, it's not a bad thing.
There was a lot of talk before he lost about the big fight with Manny Pacquiao and whatnot. So what's your take if Lamont does win? Not to look past this fight, but if he does win, what do you think? What do you think is the possibility of getting into that interview realm and the big fight realm?
That's actually what we want to be. That's where, you know, for the most part, every fighter that really fights would like to be. And he's right there. You go back in time and you look at some of these fighters, some of the fighters that fought before him and lost and end up in big fights back to back to back to back. You know, Lamont have more wins than the belt losses, two losses, and then even the amateurs. He had a stellar amateur career. So this is something that I know that he'll bounce back from. You know, the last fight with Lucas. And it's something that, you know, not only look like you said, his opponent, but, you know, he's in the way. You know, so you gotta get by him first before we even think about anybody else. But definitely Manny's and whomever else is out there at the upper weight, at 47, we definitely check.
Awesome. Dierry Jean, he's a 31-year-old who actually fights like he's 21, by the way, all the energy he has. But what do you take from Gene? What do you see him fight? What do you see?
I see, you know, the clip that I saw. He fight with passion. Very good fighter. I don't think he's great in just one area. I think he's good in a lot of areas. And based on what I heard from him, he's a hungry guy. You know, he want to experience what it's like to be a champion. And every fighter should aspire to feel that way. On the flip side, like I said, we want to keep the title.
Of course,
we like being champions. You know? So therefore, it should make for a very, very interesting fight. One want to take, and the other one want to keep.
Okay, so with that loss, and not going back to it again, I do apologize, but with that loss, it's a humbling experience, of course. So what did you tell, what was your advice to Lamont to get back up?
My advice to Lamont is simple. You know, when you revisit that fight, back to the tapes, he was putting on the boxing gloves. So much so, you can see that he was loading up on the shots, falling down, and getting frustrated early. I didn't think he was really frustrated that day. That was our intention, to make him frustrated, make him take a chance, leave a set. So then we could stick it in him after 6-6 and beyond. That was going to be at the time. But after he got the blows in the back of the head, you know, that dog came out, you know, which, you know, a lot of times often, go back to Mark's history, but never. You know, and I told him, this is not personal. This game is more cerebral. It should be more than it is physical. Had you not lost your cool, had you stayed on your grind, stayed on the plan, stayed on the boxing, the outcome should have been different. My mind, I think, would have been different. You know, you go back to Lucas and Danny. Danny got hit the same way, but he stayed in his plan. And that's what got him on the top. So that's the one thing that I think that we took from that fight that I want to really, really focus on. And that's to be focused. Not from 1 to 2, but from 1 to 12.
And what are your expectations on Lamont this 2014?
Hey, if Lamont does what Lamont is truly capable of doing, like I explained to you earlier, you know, what got us here was, you know, Lamont's ability to think his way through the fight, especially in the amateurs. You know, most of his pro fights. The last several fights, we were in fights that we had to hunt the fighter down. And I think he got more used to hunting fighters down than he did in boxing. So I want to get back to more of what got us there in the first place, is more boxing. And of course, it's nice to know that if you're in a tight spot, you can fight your way out of that spot. So, you know, boxing first, fight now.
Well, I'm here with the one and only Barry Hunter. I do appreciate your time, sir.
No problem.
This is BehindTheGloves.com. This is a side knock.